Good day. Today our topic is mathematical modeling with dimensional analysis. Here, what is dimensional analysis? Dimensional analysis is the analysis is used to identify the relationship between different physical quantities such as length, mass and time. Here, the dimensional analysis can be classified it into two types. Those are fundamental dimensions and derived quantities or secondary dimensions. Here, what is fundamental dimensions? It is a method of dimensions. All physical quantities are measured by comparison of arbitrary fixed value like length, capital L. The room can be measured as like length, breadth, width, but all the dimensions are comes under length, so that breadth can be expressed with the length and width can be expressed as like length, and then mass can be expressed with the capital M. If I want to bring the vegetable, means I can estimate that it into mass, and if I want to bring any engineering components, means I can express the term with the mass. So the second important physical quantity is mass, and then third one is time. If I want to study about the motion of the object, motion of the particle, means I should aware about time. These three quantities, which are length, mass and time, are the fixed dimensions. These fixed dimensions are called fundamental dimensions or fundamental quantity. And then second one is secondary dimensions or derived quantities. Generally, the derived quantities are conformed with the fundamental quantities. For example, if you are consider the density is the physical quantity, means the density can be expressed with the formula of mass per unit volume. The mass generally give the dimension with as like kilogram. The unit volume can be expressed with the formula of length into breadth into width. This kilogram mass can be represented as like capital M divided by length into breadth into width. Length can be expressed with L. Breadth also can be expressed with the length as L. Width also can be expressed with the length L. So that L into L into L, I can get L cube. So this derived quantity can be expressed as like M divided by L cube. So which is also can be expressed as like M into L power minus 3. Likewise, I can express the secondary dimensions with the derived quantities from fundamental dimensions, which are mass and length. Here I can represent you the physical quantity with respect to fundamental physical quantity, geometrical physical quantity, kinematic physical quantity and dynamic quantities. What are all the fundamental quantities are available? Yes, length, mass and time. Length can be expressed with the symbol of capital L, which has the dimensions as capital L. Generally, the length is always denoted with the capital L in dimensional analysis. The mass can be expressed with the symbol of M. In all the mathematical expressions, we can utilize M as the dimensions for mass. And time is also one of the fundamental physical quantity. The time can be expressed with the symbol of capital DT. So in every mathematical expression, the time has the dimensions of capital T. Likewise only we can represent the dimensions quantity in dimensional equation. After that, geometrical dimensions also available. In that, geometrical physical quantity, area is one of the physical quantities. So area can be expressed the symbol of capital A, and we can derive this area from breadth into width. From breadth can be expressed with L, and width also can be expressed with capital L. From this I can get L square, which is the derived quantity from fundamental quantity I can get. And then volume, length into breadth into width, which is the formula for volume, so that I can get the dimensions for volume is L cube, because length also has L dimension, breadth also has L dimension, and width also so has L dimension, so that if I multiply with each other means I can get L cube. So the dimension of volume is L cube. And the kinematic quantities also we can express with the symbols and the dimensions. For example, if I consider discharge, discharge can be expressed with the area into velocity. Here, how can I express area? Because area is the geometric quantity. Area can be expressed as like breadth into width, and the velocity can be expressed as like distance traveled by time. Here you see breadth is L and width is L, so that L square I can get. Distance traveled always represented with the length, so that I can utilize the symbol of capital L. And time is always denoted by capital T. Here I can solve this dimension, I can get L cube by T, and I can get L cube into T power minus 1, so that every equation I can represent the dimensions as like this L cube T power minus 1, or otherwise L cube M power minus 1. Likewise, I can represent with respect to derived quantities. After that, dynamic quantities is also one of the physical quantity variety. So one of the examples of dynamic quantity is force. Force can be expressed as like mass into acceleration. So mass is the fundamental quantity capital M, which can be denoted by capital M. And the acceleration can be expressed with the length divided by time square. So mass can be represented with the capital M into length can be expressed with the capital L, time can be expressed with the capital T, so that the formula is M into L divided by 2T square, which can be expressed as like M L into T power minus 2, which is the dimension for force physical quantity. The similar to same, if I want to calculate the density as a dimension, means generally the density can be expressed in the formula of mass per unit volume. So mass has M and unit volume has breadth into length into width. From this I can get L cube, so that M divided by L cube can be expressed as like M into L power minus 3. Similarly, we can convert all the physical quantities that are available with the geometric, kinematic quantities and dynamic quantities. In that, after framing the equations, what all the important procedures are available means, first I should aware about what is dimensional homogeneity. Okay. Dimensions of each term in an equation on both sides. What are the boats? What is meant by both sides? Every equation has its own left hand side and its own right hand side. Both sides are should be in equal condition, which is the dimensional homogeneity condition. For example, if I consider output velocity of fluid flow, if I consider this container, the container output container has water. Water has the output velocity of V, but it has the pressure head of H. From this pressure head, I can evaluate the output velocity, which is the formula available from Bernoulli's equation. I can collect this equation, which is V is equal to square root of 2GH. Here, what is the dimensions in left-hand side? Left-hand side is the V. V is the velocity. So that velocity can be expressed as like distance traveled divided by time. So distance traveled can be represented with L, and time can be expressed with capital T, which can be represented as like L into T power minus 1. And then I have to move for right hand side. In that right hand side I have square root of 2GH. So right hand side I have square root of 2GH is equal to L by T square into L. How can I get L by 2 T square? G is the acceleration due to gravity, which can be represented with meter per second square. So meter is for length and the second is for time. So that I convert that L by T square into H. H is the pressure head. Pressure head can be expressed with the length. So L by T square into L, which can be represented as L square by T square. If I remove the square root, means I can remove the square values. From this I can get L by T, which can be represented as like L into T power minus 1. Now I have to go for compare the dimensions in LHS and dimension in RHS. If I equal both, means I can get L into T power minus 1 C equal to L into T power minus 1. So both are equal. So equation V is equal to square root of 2GH is dimensionally homogeneous. So if you want to develop a mathematical model with the dimensional analysis, means you should ensure the dimensional homogeneity of developed equations likewise. The another dimensional analysis method, the one of the best methods is called as Rayleigh's method. This Rayleigh's method is used to determine the mathematical model for a response which depends on maximum 3 or 4 variables. For example, if you are considered your experiment has 2 or 3 variables, means we can utilize this Rayleigh's method. But the physical variable, I mean input parameters, are more than 3 or 4 variables, means we can't utilize this Rayleigh's method. But how can we solve or how can we develop the mathematical model with the Rayleigh's method? Let's see. Let X is the response or dependent variable which depends on x1, x2 and x3. So the general term x may be a velocity, x1, x2 and x3 are the independent variable for developing that velocity, which are the responsible factors for developing that response. So these are all called as independent variable, and output is always called as response or dependent variable. Then according to Rayleigh's method, we can express this x is a function of x1, x2 and x3, and mathematically it can be written as like capital X, which is means by response, is equal to function of f of x1 comma x2 comma x3. Likewise I can represent, for example, if I consider this response from the conducted experiment, means I can express the same equation with some mathematical form. How can I express this term as like a mathematical form? Yes, this can be written as like capital X C equal to K into x1 power A into x2 power B into x3 power C. Because if I may utilize different workpiece material or different fluids for developing the mathematical model, for I develop the generalized constant. This constant is called as K. The different workpiece material has different noise. Based on that noise, I can produce this K value. After that, x1 power A, every parameter develops its own coefficient values, which means arbitrary powers, which can be represented as like x1 in power A. X2 is a parameter, another parameter, which is also represented with another arbitrary power B, and x3 is also one of the other input parameters which is also has its own arbitrary power, which can be represented x3 power C. Likewise, we can frame the mathematical model with the Rayleigh's method. For understanding purpose, I can utilize this dimensional analysis, which means Rayleigh's method, for material removal rate in turning operation. How can we frame the equation? Let's see. You may consider different responses for your experiment, but for your understanding, I can explain with one of the examples as like material removal rate. So material removal rate in turning operation can be defined with the functions of volume of material removed divided by time. So volume can be represented with V and time can be represented with T. Here we should ensure the dimensions in left hand side is equal to dimensions in right hand side. For the reason, I should identify the dimensions in left hand side. What is the dimension for material removal rate? Always denoted with the mm cube divided by time second. Okay, so which can be expressed as like L cube by T, and also which can be written as like L cube into T power minus 1. After that, I have to go to evaluate the right hand side dimension in right hand side. The what are the terms available with the right hand side of this equation? Volume of material removed divided by time. So volume can be represented with the length into breadth into height. So the volume of material removed can be represented with the L cube, and the time can be represented with the capital T. So this can be represented with the L cube into T power minus 1. Now the dimensions in left hand side is L cube into T power minus 1, and the dimension in right hand side is L cube power T minus 1. So now I can equate both the things, and also the left hand side and the right hand side are equal in both. Okay, and from this analysis I can develop the mathematical model for material removal rate C equal to K. K is the constant for different workpiece material into depth of pad. Every workpiece material has the different ranges of depth of cut. From this range, I can identify the arbitrary exponent value, which is A. So depth of cut into the second input parameter for getting the material removal rate in machine is feed. So feed power B. B is the arbitrary exponent which can be derived from different workpiece material experimental data. I can get the B value, and then the material removal rate, another input parameter is spindle speed. Spindle speed power C, which can be also collected from experimental data for conducting the experiment with the different workpiece material. I can get the value of C. From this, I can get the final dimension is L cube into T power minus 1. Likewise, I may get the equation. Here I have another question. Why I consider depth of cut, feed rate, spindle speed? Yes, here material removal rate is the response, but this response is mainly depends on the machine tools, depth of cut, feed rate and spindle speed. So I multiply both variables with each other, and I can multiply with the K constant because the parameter are constant for all workpiece material, but the output or data are varies with the every set of experiments because of sound and noise from the experimental setup. For the reason, I have to utilize the K value, and every depth of cut has different value with every workpiece material, so that I can find the arbitrary function for arbitrary exponent for different workpiece material of depth of cut, feed rate and spindle speed. Likewise, you can develop the mathematical model for your experiment. Now you are aware about how do you develop the mathematical model with the dimensional analysis. Thank you.